you can play Nintendo Wii games in HD legally with Nintendo's full support right now, or, well, soon, if you happen to live in a certain country. These games include Mario Galaxy, Twilight Princess, and Punch-Out. But you heard right. You could play those games in HD. Now, obviously, we know Twilight Princess HD existed for Wii U, so you can actually play Twilight Princess in HD right now. But we're talking about the OG release on Wii. You can play Mario Galaxy, Twilight Princess, Punch-Out, and probably several more titles in HD right now. Or, well, soon. On a NVIDIA Shield. Only if you live in China. Hey everyone, I am Nathaniel Ruffeljantz, and we're talking about this interesting story out there that comes from ZHugeX Daniel Ahmed over on Twitter. He happens to be a analyst at Nikko Partners covering digital games market in China and Southeast Asia. And he's actually even got screenshots and images to go along with this that we are taking a look at right now. This includes the Shield, TV, etc. Essentially, what he says is that this is an official partnership between NVIDIA, iQIYI, and Nintendo to bring Wii games to NVIDIA Shield. Apparently, he first reported on this back in January, and the announcement says that there are more Wii games coming, and that these games will run in HD. Now, he does note he's not exactly sure what HD means per se, as in, does it actually mean 720p or 1080p? Is it upscaled? Is it new textures? We don't really know exactly what HD means, outside of the fact that it's obviously a resolution bump over the 480 that we played them on the Nintendo Wii. So what does this mean? What implications does this have? I don't know. It does implicate that Nintendo is putting their Wii games in HD for NVIDIA, and it does specify that this partnership they have with them over the Tegra X1 extends beyond the Nintendo Switch. This is the benefit that NVIDIA is getting in China, in that they are getting Nintendo's games. Now, does this mean that the Switch isn't going to release in China? No, that does not mean the Switch isn't going to release in China, because the Shield itself is not going to get Nintendo Switch games. And right now, you cannot play Wii games of any type, whether in HD or original format, on the Switch as is, although it could be part of Virtual Console in the future. I know, knock on wood, that we actually get Virtual Console. But beyond that, we also have to consider some other things out there, like the fact that Nintendo is obviously going to make money on these games being on the Shield when people purchase it. This would mark Nintendo's third platform now, if you count smart devices like mobile phones and tablets, that Nintendo is bringing their games to legally. Now, obviously, a lot of us have been able to play Wii games in HD for some time. There's plenty of emulators out there, Dolphin being the most popular one that was the original GameCube emulator, and since the Wii hardware is basically a GameCube, it didn't take long to start emulating Wii games, and we've seen a lot of Wii games in HD. In fact, a lot of the screenshots you are seeing now are images of the said three games that are going to be happening on this platform probably at launch in China in HD through a Dolphin or Dolphin emulator or whatever. It's happening. These games are going to be in HD. The screenshots you're seeing now are not indicative of what the final product is going to be, but just to give you an idea of what these games look like in HD. So it's going to be interesting. The NVIDIA Shield itself is going to be priced at RMB 1499, a decent price in China. The Shield itself is going to be focusing on games in China, you know, such as the games like Tencent makes. And it's also going to run popular PC games. League of Legends, as an example, is really popular in the Asian countries. And it's going to run Nintendo Wii games, as we previously discussed. So this is just a huge thing to me for a couple of reasons. First off, Nintendo releasing games from their old platforms on another system that is not their own. Granted, we know they have a tight relationship, but this is not a Nintendo platform. This is the Shield. It existed before the Nintendo Switch, before there was even a partnership between NVIDIA and Nintendo. So, very interesting that Nintendo's putting Wii games on that platform. In addition, these games are in HD. What could this mean for the future of Switch? Could we be seeing HD Wii games on Switch? Because if the games are already being put in HD for the NVIDIA Shield, what's to prevent these games from being in HD on the Nintendo Switch, which is using the exact same technology as the NVIDIA Shield? Absolutely nothing. That's what's so brilliant about this. Nintendo might be giving the Shield these Wii games exclusively in China, meaning that Nintendo might never release these games, these Wii HD games, on a Switch in China, if they ever release a Switch in China, which hasn't happened yet. But the rest of the world, they could take these games they're putting in HD that maybe arrive first in China on the Switch in the future. Now, I don't know. I mean, is this a hint? Are we finally getting a hint at Virtual Console here? I know, right? It seems crazy to even think about that. We're talking about Nintendo's putting their games on another platform entirely, and that could lead to Virtual Console. But because the NVIDIA Shield uses the Tegra X1 already, the NVIDIA Shield is basically a Nintendo Switch without the screen. Because you're seeing these images, you're seeing them advertised, what we call in the United States the Shield TV, rather than the thing that attaches onto the controller. This is good news. This is good news. And the thing is, the Shield, with support of Wii games and popular PC games and such, will probably do well in China, because unlike these under-TV gaming boxes, these digital-only gaming boxes that haven't really taken off in places like the United States or Japan, China's a different market because they haven't had official products that have had official branding and support from companies like Nintendo. Yes, we know IQ has been Nintendo's brand there for a while. They own that company, and that's how they've released systems like N64 and SNES and stuff in the past. But because of the strict regulations that came along around the Wii era through the Wii U era, Nintendo hasn't really had a presence in China at all. So this could basically allow the Shield to sell on the premise that, hey, look, we're basically the Wii, but we're offering the games in HD. Hello, Wii HD, what I thought Nintendo should have did back in 2010. And they are offering, obviously, popular PC games to go along with it, making it a very enticing product for Chinese gamers who are just now starting to get options in their gaming life. This is good. This is good news for Chinese gamers. This is also good news for Nintendo. Since the Switch itself uses the same technology, it is literally like flipping a Switch. They just have to be like, Switch, and bring these games over to Switch. That's why this makes so much sense for Nintendo. If you're going to maintain this partnership with NVIDIA and help them make money while you make some extra money and some penetration in the Chinese market, at the same time that you're putting work into bringing these games into HD for them, these games are also reusable and transferable over to Switch, and you could create a virtual console environment or subscription environment or whatever sort of environment they want. I am pumped because Nintendo still won't talk about virtual console, but it feels like this official like announcement thing from NVIDIA is almost semi-confirming that we're going to have Wii games in HD. And we're not talking, I mean, the fact that they mentioned Twilight Princess specifically, we're not talking about Twilight Princess HD on Wii U. We're talking about the OG game in HD. This is, I'm excited. And the thing is, I'm all excited about Twilight Princess because I'm a big Zelda fan. But, hello, Super Mario Galaxy in HD. Punch-Out apparently in HD. Let's do it. It looks like they also have a screenshot of a new Super Mario Brothers Wii that's in HD. However, of course, that's not an officially announced title at this time. But they did say there's going to be more Wii games coming. These are obviously just the titles they have working right now. I'm pumped. I'm excited. I hope you're excited too, because I think this is a hint. I think we finally have a hint that not only are we going to get some form of virtual console on Switch, this is the first time I've had any real hope of that in a long time, but that we might get Wii games in HD. Of course, where's the GameCube games on virtual console, HD or otherwise? I don't know. I don't know where they are. You tell me. I don't know. I mean, we're still waiting for all the Wii U games to come to Switch as well. So maybe I shouldn't get ahead of ourselves. But if these games already exist on HD on the same tech that that the Switch uses, then why the heck would we not get those games? I'm just pumped. Obviously, further frustrations could set in as we get to the end of 2018. This comes out in China, gets like 30 Wii games in HD, and we hear nothing about those games coming to Switch. I might start getting a little agitated, but I feel like we're going to hear about this potentially at the January Nintendo Direct. Feel like that would be a huge get for Nintendo. I hope that doesn't mean that they ignore the GameCube era. Since GameCube and Wii Tech are similar, what about GameCube games in HD if you're going to go that far? Very interested to see what this leads to. But you guys let me know if this raises your excitement level, even just a little bit, because this is happening. Nintendo and NVIDIA have partnered up with the NVIDIA Shield releasing in China, and they're going to have Wii games in HD. Whatever that means. 720, 1080, brand new assets, upscaling, we have no idea, but I'm pumped. Anyways, folks, I'm Nathaniel RoboJance from Nintendo Prime. If you like this video, you know what to do. And if you dislike the video, hit that dislike button. Subscribe for more content. And I will catch you in the next one.